Here comes Milano, but it's Casper Van Uden. Here comes Groenewegen on the inside. Groenewegen, did he take it on the line? Casper Van Uden is the stage winner. It was a fantastic sprint for Van Uden.
Casper Van Uden upset some of the more fancied sprinters to win the first stage of the ALULA Tour yesterday, and the young Dutchman is relishing the prospect of a first day in the leader's green jersey.
For me, it doesn't add more pressure. I think my goal is succeeded, so we can just have fun and ride the best way we can, and we just enjoy it, and hopefully we can do something again today, but we will see.
Today's punchy finish is likely to prove too tough for the pure sprinters, but it could be perfect for a man like Søren Werenskiold, who won last year on the uphill drag to Abu Raqqa.
Yeah, it's a little bit, it's not as steep, but I think it will suit me well, so just have to time the lead out so it goes a little bit down, so just have to keep the momentum into the climb so the other guys don't come from behind, we will see.
Brian Cockart also likes a tough sprint, and he's wearing one of the luckiest numbers in cycling.
You're wearing number 51. You have a smile on your face because you know about number 51.
Yeah. I have 51 win in professional. And I tried today to take the 52.
Today's final could also be important in the context of overall victory, and the British champion Fred Wright has promised to liven things up.
My plan is to, you know, pick up as many bonus seconds as I can on the way to the final climb, and yeah, try and survive, not lose too much time to the climbers, and then yeah, try and win the overall, go for the GC, why not?
Stage 2 is the longest of this year's edition, with a shade under 200 kilometres to cover between Winter Park and the Charan Nature Reserve. There is also a bit more wind forecast today, so there'll be a greater threat of echelons. The final drag to the finish line will really sting the legs, with average gradients of around 6%, so the punchier sprinters could end up vying for victory with some of the GC contenders. There was a bit of crosswind action before the live pictures began, with the peloton splitting into four groups at one point, but everything had calmed down with around 65 kilometres to go. Once again, there were five riders in the breakaway, with several of the same teams as yesterday on the move. Euskaltel Euskadi were this time represented in orange by Enekoiets Asparren, who discovered this race last year. Andreas Miltiadis, a 13-time champion of Cyprus, was up there for the Terengganu cycling team, along with two riders from Rujai Insurance. Tej Bayar Batshai Khan, the winner of last year's Tour of Thailand, and Polychronis Tortsakis, the Greek time trial specialist who made that late attack yesterday. The fifth member of the group was Atsushi Oka from JCL Team Yukio, who was quickest at the first intermediate active sprint. Today's bonus sprint had come early, with Zabia Asparren, Enekoiets' brother, taking the 3 seconds ahead of Anders Halland Johannesson and Artison Pansard. With 55 kilometres to go, the breakaway had a lead of around 3.5 minutes, with the peloton being driven by Jacob Alula, Sudal Quickstep and DSM Firmenich Post NL on behalf of their race leader, Casper Van Uden. The bunch ploughing into a cross headwind, and they were clearly wary of being caught out again. A sudden injection of pace quickly brought the gap down to under 2 minutes. Movistar trying to force some splits on behalf of their leader Davide Formolo, last year's runner-up, who was selected ahead of the defending champion Ruben Guerrero. No luck, but a few nerves in the peloton caused a crash, with one of the Saudi national riders going to ground hard.
Oh, and a crash. One of the Saudi riders has just hit the deck with a very big fall. This looks like Ahmed Al-Omrani.
The breakaway had meanwhile reached the second intermediate active sprint, and Ocker took another 3 points ahead of Bat Saikhan. Their fun at the front was soon over, though. They were swallowed up by the peloton with 34.5 kilometres remaining. Well, here's something you don't see every day, a mini sandstorm, which luckily didn't hit the peloton. We saw Simon Yates caught out by a late puncture yesterday. Today, it was Formolo's turn.
Problem here, right-hand side of the road for David Formolo. This is not good news because this race right now is full on. Formolo has a problem.
The Italian chasing hard with the help of his teammates, Johan Jakobs and Mathias Norsgaard. Meanwhile, the peloton were getting a front row seat of one of the most spectacular sights in this part of the world, or indeed anywhere in the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, the UNESCO World Heritage Site of Hegra, which will host the start of Friday's fourth stage. Perhaps the bunch slowed down to get a better look. Either way, Formolo was safely back in with just over 16k to go. Everyone starting to jostle for position on the run-in, with the speed really increasing as they suddenly moved into a tailwind section. The peloton starting to thin out as the road began to rise, with Cofidis working on the front for Kokar. It was no real surprise to see Groenewegen dropped. He had, at any rate, been struggling with illness. And then the GC favourites began to make their moves. Rafał Majka was the first man to light it up for UAE Team Emirates. His teammate Finn Fisher-Black then had a go. Simon Yates also right up there. But the most decisive-looking attack came from Pierre Latour.
Soren Vanenskjold is there with his Uno X team. They're trying to line this one up, but Latour has still got a little bit of an advantage for Total Energy. Have Uno X got enough? 500 metres to go. It's still Pierre Latour of Total Energy. He is still there. He is still holding on. They're desperately trying to close the gap now. Uno X are trying to fire with Vanenskjold. Is Pierre Latour going to get it on the line? It's a furious sprint. Latour is caught. Here goes Soren Vanenskjold. Soren Vanenskjold all the way to the line. He was the favourite. Vanenskjold takes it for Uno X Mobility.
Soren Vanenskjold becomes just the third rider to win multiple stages of the ALULA Tour, along with Groenewegen and Phil Bauhaus. The 23-year-old Norwegian securing his seventh career victory and showing he is a force to be reckoned with in these punchy finishes. As a bonus, the Uno X Mobility man takes over from Van Uden as the race leader.
It was a little bit easier than the one we had last year. That was really steep, so this one was even better for me. And we wanted to stay in the front, but not too far up in the peloton in the last 4K. So we did perfect, and then we just tried to gather on the top and just try to keep the momentum in the last 500 meters, because yeah, it goes a little bit uphill, so you don't want to lose the power. So. Which just, yeah, timed it perfect.
Vanenskjold winning ahead of Henok Mulubrahan, the two-time African road race champion. Niels Eekhoff and Van Uden both made the top five for DSM Firmenich Post-NL, either side of Kokar. Vanenskjold and Van Uden are level on time, but the Norwegian leads the race by virtue of better stage rankings. He is also now on top in the red jersey standings, leading by just a point from Van Uden. Mulugrahan and Kroonevagen have 12 apiece. Okker replaces Unai Zubeldia as leader of the most active rider competition. They both have 6 points, but the Japanese rider is better placed overall. And like Van Uden yesterday, Verenschkold has 3 jerseys. He is also our best young rider. Tomorrow should be a more classic sprint stage between ALULA International Airport and the ALULA Camel Cup track. So do join us again on Thursday, and thanks for watching.